T cells fight infections in our bodies. They spot, attack, and kill invading viruses and bacteria. But sometimes, certain T cells can mistake our body's own proteins for a target. This is the case in people with type 1 diabetes.
For reasons that are unclear, those T cells get activated and they get turned on to attacking beta cells.
Dr. Tom Serwold's lab at Joslin Diabetes Center aims to better understand T cell development and education.
You can think of T cells as sort of like policemen in that they constantly traffic throughout the body and they interact with lots of other cells and lots of other tissues, and they're actively searching out for cells that are infected with bacteria or virus.
They use discarded remnants of protein stuck to the surfaces of infected cells as signposts, letting them know which cells to strike. T cells learn what to fight and what to ignore in a small organ called the thymus, found in the upper chest behind the breastbone. There, T cells learn from their teachers, or thymic epithelial cells, which proteins are supposed to be in the body and which should be targeted. For example, in the thymus, teacher cells present the T cells with insulin.
That enables the T cells that are developing to become educated to insulin. And so the T cells that can react to insulin are generally eliminated within the thymus.
The T cells that respond to the bacterial viral antigens are the so-called good T cells, so they should get the okay signal and leave the thymus.
In type 1 diabetes, T cell education goes wrong, and the T cells primed to go after insulin get released into the body. These miseducated T cells locate beta cells and destroy them.
And so what my lab's trying to do is we're studying that process, and with the goal of trying to enhance the deletion of T cells with receptors that can attack beta cells. We think if we could make the thymic epithelial cells express more insulin or other proteins that are specifically expressed normally in beta cells, that we could increase the level of tolerance to beta cells and decrease the likelihood of a T cell attack on beta cells.
One experiment looks to capture the beta cell-sensitive T cells so their exact molecular makeup can be further studied.
We're going to place something we call a trap, which is a small like tablet which you put inside the mouse, and there where T cells are homing to this. And then we can take the T cells from there and study them in detail. And what is really interesting, if we move into humans and study T cells there, and then we can see what initiates type 1 diabetes and the recurrence and other mechanistic studies, which would eventually lead us to possible therapies, because we would understand how these T cells attack the beta cells.
If a treatment to re-educate T cells comes to fruition, it could be applied before beta cells become destroyed or just after type 1 diabetes diagnosis, in the hopes that some beta cell function will be preserved. And along with beta cell transplantation, T cell therapy would be one of a two-pronged approach to a cure.
What my lab is working on is to prevent the autoimmunity, and so that's one wing. And we think that's going to be highly complementary to the other wing, which is the beta cell replacement, but it's going to take both.